Freya's temple. The ring is just as beautiful. As I'd remembered.
Freyr.
A Vanir god. Freyr's brother, actually.
Freyr has a long history with the elves. One of the few gods welcome here.
Hopefully you'll find some clues about the three legendary ingredients inside this stronghold. I can do whatever you need. I suppose you prefer my brother's work? You're wrong, of course.
Now where should we go?
This will be our best work yet. Just need a little help from you lot. This will be our best work yet. Just need a little help from you lot.
Something down there. Thank you, by the way.
For what?
For saving me. I know I screwed things up before Balder grabbed me.
You did. But you are my son.
Thank you.
Boy, over here.
It says, glory to Mjolnir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Conan's Guard.
Whoa. Look.
I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
Whoa. Look, it's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Jade, I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
One vicious son of a bitch.
Prepare yourself!
I'm ready! He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit. Hi, lad. That's me powerful.
Ned is having fun with you. Done here.
That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
strong.
Over there! Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vedergaard.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
'Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Dvegrath Eaker, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
these boy or girl dragons?
I do not know.
A few ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
This dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to free it.
Atreus, to me.
apple doesn't fall far.
Boy.
Sir. Hold on. Let me read this. dwarf thing want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dvay Grathekir. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well,
so, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so. Looks like it needs three entry stones. Still won't open? Looks like we need three.
Enemies ahead!
Thank you.
Okay. Here we go. Huh. It's kind of run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess. Maybe the throne room's... in better shape.
Another one here.
Stargather. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
It looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just old spirits, I suppose. Leftover victims of the Mad Dwarf's reign. Still, that's rather ominous.
They're getting louder. They sound almost like... Hella!
Where's a passage behind this throne?
A secret passage!
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Signir.
Boy, over here.
Ah, I was wondering about this. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
wonder what this place looked like in better times.
Conansgard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The Dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
Trust is a gamble, like you said, and the Dwarf King lost.
Okay, brother.
You boys look right beaming.
We found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We get our ways.
Oh.
Thank you. Hey, nobody's twisting your arm.
Thank you.
Brother, look down there.
Ah!
is again. I swear it looks like the Jotunheim Tower. But only for a second. Okay. What about the giant with eight arms?
Starkath the Mighty, he was called.
If the giants ever had anything so organized as an army, Starkath would have been their general. An opinion in retrospect, I should have kept to myself. But no, as Odin's advisor, I kept him advised. And having bent his will towards Starkath's doom, there was no dissuading him. Well, I can just tell you this story later. Right then, where were we? Ah, yes. Odin was plotting the downfall of Starka, the mighty eight-armed giant. But even Thor wasn't stupid enough to take on Starkath on his own. No. Instead, the Aesir set forth slanders upon Starkath's name, branding him throughout the realms as a monster to be feared. They said he abducted an elf queen who killed herself rather than be ravished by the giant. Lies, of course, but you're too young for her story. In the end, even the Vanir gods and the armies of Midgard were roused to the cause. They surrounded Starka, showered him with arrows until he was brought to his knees. He surrendered, hoping by trial he could clear his name. Thor took advantage and ripped off one of Starkath's arms, which only made it easier to sever another and another until he was satisfied. Relieved of six arms and too much blood, Starkath perished. On the battlefield. Ah, I regret it to this day, you know. I told myself there was nothing I could do, but I wish I'd tried.